War. War never changes, but the weapons to wage it with are constantly evolving, and they've never evolved faster than in modern times. Even as new technology has unlocked all manner of improvements to our life, it's also created the most lethal military weapons ever invented. But which topped the list of the most lethal modern military weapons? What weapon rules the modern battlefield? Let's find out. America's F-22 Raptor. Pound for pound, the American F-22 Raptor is the undisputed ruler of the skies. While originally detracted for its inability to dogfight, the fact is that the days of close-range dogfighting are well and truly over. Modern anti-air weapon systems, long-range acquisition and tracking, and the sheer speed of modern fighter jets make a traditional dogfight a thing of fiction. That's why the US military went all in on optimizing the F-22 to be a stealthy long-range assassin. While its stealth characteristics vary, just as with any stealth aircraft, on the angle the plane presents to incoming radar waves, at its most optimal angles the F-22 gives off the same radar signature as that of a flying marble. While no plane is truly invisible, the F-22 is the most survivable stealth fighter in the sky today. But stealthiness is only half of the equation, because what makes the F-22 truly lethal is its incredible ability to detect targets at extremely long range and network with other battlefield assets including drones, airborne radar, other planes, and even satellites. With such low observability and beyond visual range engagement capabilities, the F-22 is a first-look, first-shoot aircraft, with missiles incoming to enemy fighters before they've even detected the F-22. Unfortunately, the F-22 is only built in small numbers, with the US Air Force operating 187 of a planned fleet of hundreds. With the advent of the global war on terrorism, funding priorities quickly shifted elsewhere, and the costly aircraft, coming in at $150 million a unit, was nixed to the current operational fleet. It was decided at the time that the F-22 was simply so advanced that no other nation presented a realistic threat against it, and thus large numbers of it were unnecessary. Even the Chinese Chengdu J-20 and the Russian Su-57 were deemed to be both not threatening enough and not to be produced in large enough numbers to pose a serious threat against American air forces. With China's growing ambitions in the South China Sea and rapidly modernizing military, though, the US Air Force has already begun planning for a replacement to the F-22 and the F-35 through its Next Generation Air Dominance program. Despite its low numbers, for now, the F-22, though, will remain the deadliest fighter above any battlefield it finds itself in. The F-22 may rule the skies, but our next lethal modern weapon is the undisputed king of the underwater domain. American Seawolf-class submarine. Built at the end of the Cold War, the American Seawolf class of submarines remains the most advanced submarines ever built, outclassing even the modern US Virginia-class submarines, which are replacing America's Los Angeles-class. Originally developed to counter advanced Soviet ballistic missile and attack submarines, the Seawolf was jam-packed with the most advanced technology the US has ever fielded under the sea. Out of the 29 originally planned to enter service, only 3 were ever completed due to the end of the Cold War. Much like America's F-22 Raptor, the Seawolf found itself a victim of having no realistic threat to go up against, and thus American budget priorities were shifted elsewhere. At a cost of $5 billion per sub, they're a whopping $2 billion more expensive than the modern Virginia-class subs, which are soon to become the workhorse of the American attack sub fleet. All that money was well spent on creating the stealthiest submarine to ever cruise the ocean, with an operational Seawolf described as being quieter than a Los Angeles-class submarine sitting idle at port. American sonar operators often joke that if you want to track a Seawolf, follow the silent void cruising around the ocean. All 3 original Seawolves remain in service with the US Navy, and their stealth is so formidable that they've been modified to allow for shallow water operations, such as delivering Navy SEALs and other special forces directly to enemy beaches. Famously, a Seawolf was tasked with the nearly impossible mission of tapping a Russian communications cable just offshore from a major Russian base, and the tap remained undetected and active for years. American Seawolves are rapidly approaching 30 years in service, and yet there's no sign for their imminent retirement. Another clue as to just how deadly these extremely classified submarines really are. Recognizing the growing submarine threat posed by Russia and China, the US Navy last year announced a plan to purchase a new generation of Seawolf-like subs specialized in hunting and destroying enemy submarines. Despite only 3 of its kind in service, the American Seawolf is the undisputed king of the underwater realm. The US may have the advantage in the air and below the waves, but our next weapon threatens any American aircraft finding itself in the wrong sky. Russia's S-500 air defense system. The United States has historically held the advantage in combat aircraft, forcing Russia to invest heavily, much more so than NATO, in air defense systems. This has given Russia an unrivaled expertise in creating air defense weapons, and its newest surface-to-air anti-ballistic missile system puts the American equivalent, the Patriot missile battery, to shame. The S-500 was originally planned in the late 1960s with a requirement to engage enemy aircraft up to 62 miles away. The Soviet military, however, rejected the weapon, requiring that a new air defense system be able to engage not just enemy aircraft, but the growing threat posed by ballistic missiles. Thus, the Soviets decided to invest in the S-300 family of air defense systems instead, shelving the S-500 for a few decades. Today, technology has caught up with the Soviet ambitions, delivering the most advanced air defense system in the world. Unlike many Russian military projects of late, such as the Su-57, the S-500 seems to be more than just propaganda, and American intelligence sources familiar with the details of the system confirmed a successful intercept of an airborne target at a range of nearly 300 miles. The S-500 is designed to be rapidly deployed, with mobile radar and missile vehicles which can be set up in as little as 30 minutes' time, making them very hard to pinpoint and eliminate before becoming active. Realistic estimates are that the system can track and engage up to 10 targets at once and can be used against intercontinental ballistic missiles, hypersonic cruise missiles, aircraft, and even low Earth orbit satellites. With an operational range of 370 miles, the S-500 can seriously threaten any enemy aircraft attempting to enter its domain, and is without a doubt the most lethal air defense unit in the world. The American Navy is the most powerful in the world, but even it may not be able to defend itself from our next weapon, China's DF-26 ballistic missile. China faces a serious problem in the Pacific, the U.S. Navy. Despite having a larger fleet, China's Navy remains technologically behind the U.S., and the nation is still incapable of carrying out blue water Navy operations far from home. This is a serious problem for a nation that gets more than 60% of its trade via the ocean, all coming through trade routes it cannot hope to defend in the case of a war against the U.S. or its allies or India. In response to the threat posed by the American and Indian navies, China leaned heavily into the development of the use of rocket forces, creating the world's only missile service with the People's Liberation Army Rocket Force, a military service focused exclusively on missile warfare. The latest addition to the Chinese rocket forces, the DF-26, may just be the deadliest threat facing American and Indian ships in the South Pacific. Designated as the Carrier Killer or the Guam Killer because of its intended use against American aircraft carriers and its forces on Guam, the DF-26 is a dual-use intermediate-range ballistic missile with the ability to carry a warhead weighing up to 4,000 pounds. The DF-26 packs enough explosive wallop to devastate American installations on Guam and possibly even sink a U.S. aircraft carrier with just one hit. With a range of up to 2,500 miles, the DF-26 can not just threaten U.S. forces in Guam, South Korea, and Japan, but it can target American naval vessels far out at sea, keeping American naval air power out of the fight altogether. Its ground attack variants sport a circular error of probability between 150 to 450 meters, making it less than accurate. However, as it's designed to be used in overwhelming volleys meant to oversaturate enemy air defenses, the wide targeting margin of error is largely meaningless. While it's unknown what the circular error of probability is for its ship attack variants, it's estimated that it must be no greater than 10 meters if it's to have any chance of threatening American or Indian ships. While formidable in theory, the DF-26 is not believed to have been tested against naval targets yet and requires a long kill chain of assets that China has not proven it can master or defend in the case of a war. With American carriers presenting a moving target hundreds or thousands of miles away, China's DF-26 would have to be very precise indeed if it's to succeed at its primary mission of keeping American naval air power away from its shores. China's missiles are indeed deadly, but none can top the next weapon on our list of most lethal modern military weapons, Russia's hypersonic missiles. With the United States spending the majority of the 21st century so far focused on terrorism, it's fallen far behind traditional rivals in several key areas, such as anti-submarine warfare and the development of hypersonic weapons. Of the two, none pose as great a threat to the American forces as Russia's next-generation hypersonic missiles. Already deploying several variants, some of which are nuclear-capable, the weapon that most worries U.S. officials is the Zircon family of hypersonic missiles. These weapons fly at 6 times the speed of sound, giving air defense system as little as a minute to respond to the incoming threat. If fired in a large volley at a target such as a carrier strike group, the group's air defense cruisers would have only 30 seconds or less to detect, track, and intercept before the missile's high speed brings it to target, a daunting feat even for America's Aegis air defense system. With large enough numbers, an American carrier strike group would simply be unable to respond in time to each incoming missile, ensuring multiple hits on friendly ships. That's if these missiles can even be tracked by radar in the first place, as the incredible high speeds cause a buildup of a cloud of plasma around the missile as it tears through the atmosphere, absorbing incoming radar waves. While it could still be detected by passive systems such as infrared or those that pick up the missile's electronic emissions, these are very short range in nature and typically don't provide a high enough fidelity to accurately guide an interceptor missile to its target. While not impossible to defend against, hypersonic missiles provide a significant challenge to American ships, prompting the US to invest heavily into alternative interception weapons such as laser systems which operate at the speed of light. However, with their low flight profiles, stealth features, and incredibly high speeds, detecting them in the first place remains a significant challenge that right now, the US simply has no answer for. With only an estimated 6 of these missiles being required to sink a large US ship, the American Navy finds itself under a serious threat for the first time since the Cold War. Despite the threat posed by hypersonic missiles and the new Chinese DF-26 ballistic missiles, though, the US Navy currently remains confident that it can operate in hostile waters. When pressed on the matter, Navy officials have refused to comment on specific measures, citing highly classified defensive systems in place or soon to be acquired to defend against these next-generation weapons. Still, the threat posed by Russian hypersonic missiles is seen by many as the death knell signaling the end of the aircraft carrier as the preeminent weapon of naval warfare, the giant vessel simply being too large, costly, and vulnerable to be worth the investment any longer. Ready for more military news? Check out our American vs. Chinese soldiers comparison right now, or click this other video instead.